figure out what dimensions I want the bar. I want it about as wide as my blade is gonna be because it won't gain a lot of width after this, so I think I'm gonna go about 2 inches wide. But I gotta figure out how thick I want the tiles to be. Probably like 1.25 inches or 1 inch. So it'll probably get drawn out about half the thickness, which would make them about 2 inches long. Yesterday I took the 10 pieces of 4 small bars on each side and 2 thick bars. So I took all 10 of those pieces and put them all together in a kind of a square. It was more of a rectangle. Forge welded all that, drew it out to a long bar that was like 1.25 inches square, and then cut it up and 4-weighed that again. And got it all TIG welded up and got a casing. I didn't put a casing around it, but I welded the seam, and that's where we're at today when we started. Stuck it in there and started forging it down, and that's what I've got so far. Took a look at this pattern, but I wanted to dip it again real quick so you guys could see what it's looking like. I cleaned it off. So after looking at the etch, I realized the pattern is looking super cool, but in one of the previous videos, we forged this on a 45 degree, well, it wasn't a 45 degree angle. I normally re-square it on a 45 degree angle, but this time I did it on a little bit less of an angle because I was trying to get this really cool swoopy look going down the blade with the center part of the mosaic bar. Well, because it wasn't on a 45 degree angle, what I'm used to, I forged the bar out the wrong way. See, normally when it's on a 45 degree angle, it doesn't matter which way you forge the bar out because it's symmetrical, but the bar actually became asymmetrical at that point and needed to be forged out a certain way. So I forged, the pattern is coming out just like what I drew. I'm really, really happy with it, except I should have forged it flat like this instead of like this. It's gonna be an awesome, super amazing pattern. It won't be any less of a pattern than it was going to be, but it won't have the swoopy curves going in and out anymore. Now it's gonna have more like these ridges kind of going across. They should look really cool. It may even give a cooler effect when you move it around in the light. It'll be super, super chatoyant. But the way the pattern's going now, I think it'll be more chatoyant and it'll have like more defined lines of pattern in the blade. But yeah, something to keep an eye on next time. Once you make your bar asymmetrical, you gotta pay attention to which way you forge it because it makes a difference. And I forgot to do that on this because it was the first time I've ever done this type of manipulation on the steel. It's gonna make a super amazing sword and everything still. I'm still concerned about the amount of material. I hope there's enough here, but we're ready to surface grind this thing. I'll probably mill the edge of it to get it nice and square, and then maybe surface grind the other edge once we got something square to go off of, and weld it to a bar, tack weld it to a bar, and chuck it up in the bandsaw and start cutting this up into a bunch of tiles so we can do a tile welded mosaic. Because right now the pattern's on the end of the bar, but we gotta get the pattern so it's across the face of the bar, and we're gonna do that by cutting it into little tiles and flipping the tiles over and forge welding all those together. So let's start surface grinding on this right now. Surface ground, and I also chucked it up in the milling machine and milled off one of the edges to make it square, and then I surface ground the other edge and then flipped it over and ground it down a little deeper. Get it all marked out, get the layout of where I want to cut the tiles. I'm gonna tack weld it to a bar of steel so I can easily hold the whole piece in the bandsaw at an angle while I cut it. So the way I do that is tack weld it to a piece of steel. I need to get the steel squared up first though, because I think it's kind of out of square a little bit, so I might throw it in the milling machine or something and square up the piece of steel that I'm gonna weld this to. And yeah, we'll start doing all that stuff.